In the book of 1 Kings chapter 19, we find a prophet, his name is Elijah. He went to the mount called Carmel, and it is there he established the presence of God. He told his enemies, if your God is real God, prove. But only one thing, let's go to the mountain, because Elijah knows on the mountain symbolizes the presence of God. There was an altar of God on Mount Carmel. The prophets of Baal, they were not one, they were 400 of them. They said, what is the challenge you are doing? Elijah said, if your God is a living God, you bring a bull, cut it into pieces, and you should not put fire. If your God is a really prayer listening God, living God, he should put the fire. They said, with our magical power, within a second we can bring fire. But Elijah knows very well, we are living in a world which is filled with black magic, soothsaying, all kinds of evil filled world. But if you fill yourself with the presence of God, no evil can touch you. Do you know this truth? So, the previous night itself, Elijah went to the Mount Carmel, where the challenge is going to take place. He filled that place with the presence of God. That's why sometimes we ask the priests to bless our houses. Sometimes we ask to bless the things with the presence of God. So Elijah, he filled that place with the presence of God, with fasting and praying. He went around the place, filling the place. Lord, fill this place with your presence. When there is light, darkness cannot come inside naturally. So when Elijah prayed that place with the presence of God, the next day morning, 420 Baal prophets came. They brought their bull. They cut the bull into pieces. The place in which already Elijah has prayed and filled with the divine presence, they are trying to call on their God. Nothing is happening. They are wondering. Outside, when we say one mandram, one magical, one prayer, satanic power was working. Now no power is working. Why there is no fire? Afternoon, nothing happened. Elijah was making fun of them. Maybe your God is taking siesta. Call him. Loud, he may come. 420 of them could not do anything. You may be one man. If you bring forth the presence of God, let 420 people come against you, they cannot touch you. The God who is inside you, greater than any power in the world. Can you lift up your right hand, please? Number one, 1 John, please stand. 1 John, chapter 4. Verse 4. The one. Show your finger. The one.
Who is within you.
Is greater than. Any power.
In the world.
Any power. In the world.
In the world.
The one.
Who is within you.
Is greater than. Any power.
Any power.
In the world. Nilo unna yesaya.
Ilokamula unna.
Anni shaktulu kante.
Gomavadu.
Hallelujah. So Elijah, one man prayed. 420 members, they cut their hands, put the blood, nothing happened. You don't get frightened of black magic saying, nothing will happen to you. Once, few 20 years ago happened, once I went with one boy and girl to pray to a particular house, because in Chitapal Mandi, one particular house people were afraid of. What I am saying is 20 years ago, about one family, all the neighbors were frightened because that man was making black magic, they said. So I went to visit that house. That man looked at me up and down. Do you know who I am? If I say anything, what will happen to you? Do you know? Blood will come from you. I said, I have come in the name of Jesus, who has given blood for you and me.
Amen.
He got so angry. And as we were praying, suddenly the girl who came to pray along with me, she is laughing. That girl was affected by the enemy. I was holding her and praying. The boy who was next to me, he is laughing. Now we were all three holding and praying. What did we pray? Simple prayer. Lord Jesus, cleanse us with your blood. Once we are purifying ourselves, enemy will not touch us. And fill us with your Holy Spirit. Lord, cleanse us with your precious blood and fill us with your Holy Spirit. Lord, cleanse us with your precious blood and fill us with your Holy Spirit. Lord, cleanse us with your precious blood and fill us with your Holy Spirit. Small prayer. We were continuously praying. Suddenly that man said, my body is burning, burning, please go away. I said, we have not come to go away. We want the spirit of evil that is in you has to go away. He said, the evil spirit in me will kill me. I said, nothing will happen to you. We took so many things which he used for all the magical things. We tied them all and threw it away in a well. He was frightened. He came along with me. We prayed. We prayed for him. We blessed the house. He called me next day. Father, first time in my life, in this house, I slept peacefully. Some of you may be knowing, even today, that man, he became an auto driver. His name is Mr. Sebastian. He became an auto driver. God blessed him. He became a preacher. Now he is having his own vehicle to drive. Our God is a great God. You have him, all that of God will have you. Yes. When Elijah prayed, he destroyed the Baal prophets. And the next day, the evil spirit did not leave him. Today you are praying with me. The moment you go out, the enemy will come after you. He is not worried about those who don't follow the Lord Jesus, who don't spend time with him. When a man hunts, two birds are falling. One is dead, another one is slightly having little life. The man who has shot that, what will he go and catch? Is the dead one first? Dead one is always his. He can take any time. He will be trying to catch one who has little life. The enemy will after those who are after the Lord. Those who are eating, drinking, busy with the world, he will not be bothered. They are his always. Don't get upset when things go wrong. Don't move around your weakness. Enter into your strength. You will live on. Don't disturb yourself with the disturbances that happen to you. Enter into his peace. His peace will take care of your life.